do you owe the Giants, and specifically Dave Gettleman, an apology? We got a franchise quarterback.
Are you seriously sitting here on a Monday morning?
Yes.
After a performance against the hapless Bucks, one good performance, asking if I owe Gettleman an apology when he reached at number six for a quarterback that probably wasn't going to be taken in the first round. Is that really what you're asking?
I am asking you, when the defense didn't play well and Saquon Barkley got hurt. Yes, I'm asking you
that. The answer is, you're damn right I do.
There we go, my guy.
Gettleman, about Daniel Jones, Danny Dimes. And the reason I'm going to say sorry is because really, when I could argue about where you took him and this and that, and, you know, let's see what other quarterbacks who have not yet had a chance to play, you know, what they look like. It is only one game, et cetera, but guys, you know what you're looking at when you see it. Danny Dimes is right. This guy has arm talent for days, putting it on guys' back shoulders where only the offense could make a play on it. He is not scared. Clearly processing information quickly, mobile. He's a big athletic guy. Of course, the fumbles are an issue for me. It's not just like throwing picks, but it's turning the ball over, ball security. You know, especially with a mobile quarterback, you got to worry about that. That's still an issue. But this guy is the truth. You can see when a guy has it or not. You saw it from Dak Prescott in preseason. When Romo was hurt, you're like, whoa, Dak Prescott's got it. Mm-hmm. Daniel Jones has that same sort of thing, except the talent level at the same point in his career is higher, I think. He reminds me a lot of Jared Goff. And whatever you want to say about Jared Goff, he did deserve the $100-plus million. He didn't. He's not as good as this guy or is better than that guy. Jared Goff was the number one overall pick in the draft, who is the reigning and defending NFC champion right now. And Daniel Jones looks, I don't mean like he looks like he'll develop into where Jared Goff is now. He looks like Jared Goff does now already. He's really, really good. Stephen A., I'm not apologizing to Gettleman for a whole host of things I disagree. But when you identify your guy and you take him, and guys like me are killing you on air, when the guy is this talented, you got to give it up. I do. I'm apologizing to Gettleman for that one.
Well, you go ahead and you do that. Props to you. Congratulations. I'll throw you some balloons. I'm not giving him no damn apology because it does not matter in terms of what I saw yesterday from Daniel Jones. We did not, I know I did it, we didn't accuse Daniel Jones of being incapable of playing. The question was whether or not he should have been taken ahead of Haskins out of Ohio State. Remember what the argument was when we were hanging in Nashville. Nobody looked at Daniel Jones, for example, with the Giants having a couple of first-round picks and just lamented the fact that he was taken sixth overall when clearly he would might have been available later on in the first round, at the very least, as a worst-case scenario. The issue was whether or not you should take him ahead of Haskins. And until I see Haskins perform, then I will make my judgment about Daniel Jones, because if I said he couldn't play, then that would be different. That was not the argument against Daniel Jones, at least not from most NFL aficionados that I heard of, whether it was Mel Kiper Jr., Todd McShay coming on board, even though in the case of McShay, he thought Haskins, if I remember correctly, analysts like Damian Woody, like Ryan Clark and others, nobody called Daniel Jones a scrub. Nobody said he couldn't play. What folks were lamenting was whether or not he should be taken ahead of Haskins. Haskins is the backup quarterback in the nation's capital with the 0-2 Washington Redskins, just like the Giants were 0-2 last year. The difference is that Daniel Jones has had an opportunity to be seen against the Tampa Bay Buccaneers yesterday, and there's no reason to look for Dwayne Haskins at this point in time, because Case Keenum, although he's 0-2, is completing 69% of his passes. He's thrown 5 touchdowns, not a single interception this season, and clearly when you look at the Washington Redskins, who has the absolute worst running attack in football at this particular juncture, you're not necessarily blaming Case Keenum or the passing game for the maladies that afflict the Washington Redskins. Therefore, you're not going to see Haskins because Case Keenum is performing, whereas Eli Manning was not necessarily doing so. So major props to Daniel Jones for showing up and showing out. I'm going to give props to the New York Giants defense as well, that outscored at one point the Tampa Bay Buccaneers 22-3 in the second half. A matter of fact, with the exception of Janoris Jenkins getting schooled by Mike Evans, the Giants defense looked pretty solid in the second half. The issue here now is, I'm looking for when I see Haskins, because we were saying Daniel Jones should not have been taken ahead of Haskins. That's the issue.
That's legit, and Haskins hasn't gotten on the field yet. That's totally legitimate. But the issue is this, really, with Haskins. Actually, it's not. You're saying, well, we weren't saying Daniel Jones couldn't play. In fact, the analysts that we spoke to on this show, and when I researched Daniel Jones, because I didn't watch him at Duke. Who's watching Duke football? Like, let's get real about this. They all said the same thing, Stephen A. When you graded all the rookie quarterbacks, all the quarterbacks taken in the draft, Haskins ranked at or near the top in most or all of the important categories, and Jones ranked at or near the bottom. So my opining on it at the time, the opinions I was giving on TV about Gettleman and the Giants was that they seemed to be kind of arrogantly saying that we see things that no one else does. We're so good at this evaluation that we see this guy. He's going to be the quarterback, and we don't care what all the metrics say, analytics, all the other scouts. We know better.
But that's not what and you said.
But yeah, it was. I was going at him principally for that. And the issue is this. When you believe that you see the guy, you think that dude might be going to the Hall of Fame one day, right? Then whatever anyone else wants to say, get that guy as soon as he's available. I understand that way of thinking. So on the issue of Daniel Jones, I think we will see what Haskins turns into. There's no doubt. But on the issue of Daniel Jones, the people who are mocking the pick, like me, have to eat their words. And by the way, the words have never been so delicious to me because I'm a Giants.
We appreciate what's delicious to you. And more importantly, we appreciate the level of understanding that you have, because after all, you always understand stuff. None of us do. The fact of the matter is, in Nashville, let's get the footage. Most of your diatribe was about the fact they passed on Haskins. Mm-hmm. My point is, you haven't seen Haskins. Thanks for watching ESPN on YouTube. For more sports highlights and analysis, be sure to download the ESPN app. And for live streaming sports and premium content, subscribe to ESPN+.